The Whistling Season is a novel by American author and novelist Ivan Doig, who was widely known for his 16 fiction and non-fiction books set mostly in his native Montana, celebrating the landscape and people of the post-war American West. In The Whistling Season, Doig captures the life of early Western settlers in Montana. In the present day, Paul, the Montana State Superintendent of Schools, has been tasked with deciding the fate of the state's last rural schools. As he struggles with the decisions he must make, Paul recalls his childhood and the one-room schoolhouse he attended in Marias Coulee, Montana in the fall of 1909. The novel opens in 1909. In seventh grade, Paul attends the same school as his two younger brothers. The three boys, Paul, Damon, and Toby, live with their recently widowed father, Oliver. Together, they are struggling to maintain the household in the absence of their wife and mother and to keep up with the chores, which include cooking, housekeeping, attending to the farm and going to school. Quickly realizing that this is too much for all of them, Oliver decides to advertise for a housekeeper. He receives a response from a woman in Minnesota who claims that she can't cook but doesn't bite, which intrigues Oliver and the boys, who are dubious that this woman cannot cook. Oliver decides to send for her from Minnesota, only to realize that the response was all too accurate in spite of its humor. The housekeeper really cannot cook. The new housekeeper, Rose, arrives by train with her brother-in-law, Morris Llewellyn. They are just two of many traveling by train to this area, most being drawn by the promise of the Big Ditch, a gargantuan irrigation project intended to make the Montana prairie bloom. Nobody expected Morris, who continues to prove himself a character full of surprises throughout the book. Morris is a quirky character and clearly an intellectual. However, upon his arrival in Montana, he surprises himself and others with his newfound joy for manual labor, such as cutting firewood. Both Rose and Morris prove themselves to be hard workers, as Rose keeps the house in spotless condition, while Morris is happy to take on any job that Oliver can find for him, including cleaning out the chicken coop. Meanwhile, the boys find that they have to band together to overcome the constant challenges facing them at school. When Paul hits the school bully, Eddie Turley, Damon suggests that the boys compete in a horse race where each of them must ride backwards, hoping to protect his brother and prevent a potentially dangerous fight. He states that the loser of the horse race is to leave the other boy alone for the rest of the year. Damon's plan works, as Paul wins the race, all is well until their father finds out. As punishment, Paul is tasked with helping Morris stack the woodpile for their elderly aunt. During their work time together, Paul and Morris become close, and their relationship takes on a mentor and student role. The schoolteacher of their one-room schoolhouse runs off to marry a traveling minister, and Oliver talks Morris into replacing her. As Morris engages the class, the reader is engaged in the minds of the students, the Milleron home, and life in rural Montana in the early 1900s. Morris also tutors Paul in Latin after school, deepening their relationship. While assisting Rose with moving into her new home, Paul's youngest brother, Toby, gets stepped on by a horse. Toby suffers several breaks in his foot and is put on bed rest in hopes that his foot will heal and he will one day be able to walk again. Oliver doesn't know how he will take care of his son and work at the same time. It is decided that Rose will move into their home and Paul will live in Rose's house until Toby's foot is healed. 4 months, the boy who had not missed one day of school has to stay at home in bed. The closeness leads to a romance between Rose and Oliver. Paul unravels the mystery of Rose and Morris's move from the Midwest to Montana. The uncovering of this secret threatens to put an end to the Whistling Season and destroy the relationships that have been built between the Llewellyns and the Millerons. Paul discovers that Rose and Morrie are on the run after having defrauded people in Chicago. Rose's late husband was a boxer and threw a fight in order to win betting money. As a result, he was murdered. Paul does not tell his father this secret because he has grown to love Rose as a mother figure and does not want her to leave his life. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did and be sure to subscribe. Thank you.